Human urine going down the drain. For us, it's waste, but in reality, it contains one of the most essential substances on our planet, the 15th element in the periodic table, phosphorus. It was discovered 350 years ago by the German alchemist Hennig Brand. He collected 50 buckets of human urine and heated it intensely, distilling it and distilling it. He was searching for the Philosopher's Stone, which was thought to turn base metal into gold. What he actually found was a white powder, phosphorus, which for us humans is far more precious than gold. I've got some of it here. Without phosphorus, plants couldn't grow or produce fruits and seeds, and animals, including us, couldn't survive. It's a key element in our cells and bones, and in our very DNA. In the last 350 years since phosphorus was discovered, it's changed our lives. Here at Lancaster University, we're celebrating the anniversary by bringing together people from around the world who are researching and working with this amazing element. Why does it fascinate us so much?
Phosphorus is essential for life.
Phosphorus is essential for food production to feed the world.
Phosphorus is the stardust that helps us grow.
Phosphorus is all around us. It's in lots of products that we use every day.
Every time we drive our car, it's in car batteries.
Or eat processed food, it's added as a preservative.
Or close the curtains, it's in flame retardants.
Or paint our home.
Or brush your teeth.
Or clean the toilet.
Or strike a match.
It's highly combustible. Phosphorus bombs created the firestorm that devastated Hamburg in the Second World War. So it has its dark side, but it also has huge benefits for humanity.
Phosphorus fertilizer helped fuel the green revolution, doubling grain production globally. Over 90% of the phosphorus we use is in food production and processing. The crops that we grow with phosphorus fertiliser don't only just feed ourselves, but also feed the animals that we grow for food production. But also we have to add phosphorus directly to animal feed for some animals such as pigs and poultry. So without phosphorus fertiliser, we would not be able to produce the food that we need.
We get much more phosphorus than we need in a modern diet. So a lot ends up literally flushed down the toilet. What can we do about that?
Well, much of that phosphorus will end up in a treatment works where we treat wastewater, including human sewage. And here, phosphorus is an environmental pollutant, but also a potentially valuable resource. And as a nation, we spend many millions of pounds a year removing phosphorus from wastewater. Much of this will end up in the sludges that are produced at our treatment works. So we can treat these sludges to produce a material that can be supplied to farmers to apply to their soils as a fertiliser to help us produce crops.
Less than half the phosphorus we use in farming ends up on our plates. So where does the rest go?
Yeah, so a lot of it is just retained in the soil. And then sometimes when we have big heavy rainstorms, it can just get washed right into the river where it can cause problems there in terms of like water quality.
Phosphorus loss from farming and water treatment works is the top reason that our rivers and lakes aren't reaching good ecological status. So phosphorus can cause algal blooms. This can have deadly toxins for livestock and pets. It can cause sores and illnesses in humans as well. Decomposing algae takes oxygen out of the water and can lead to fish dying.
The big question for me and my fellow scientists then is how to balance the benefits of phosphorus with its dangers. For many years, there's been a slow natural phosphorus cycle that kept the element in balance. Phosphorus, weathered from the mineral called apatite in phosphate rock, entered the soil. Plants extracted phosphorus from the soil, animals ate the plants and excreted the phosphorus, returning it back to the soil. But then, as the population grew, we started to disrupt the natural cycle. We needed more food, so we began to mine phosphate rock to use on crops around the world. Today, 270 million tons of phosphate rock are mined every year. The slow phosphorus cycle has become a one-way conveyor belt. It takes many millions of years for phosphate rock like this to form. Yet in the last 50 years, we've exploded phosphorus into our Earth system, polluting watercourses and using up this precious and finite resource. How much have we got left?
We're not really sure. We've probably got only about a few hundred years left. The UK has got none of its own, so we're totally reliant on other countries such as Morocco. And we can't manufacture phosphorus synthetically, so we're totally reliant on rock deposits. So when it's all gone, it's all gone. And what do we eat then?
That's why Paul is leading a major project to establish how phosphorus use can be made more sustainable in the UK. Refocus. Can we get rid of the one-way phosphorus conveyor belt and recreate a more sustainable phosphorus cycle, just like that found in nature?
The Refocus project aims to determine the resilience of the UK food system to a future phosphorus scarcity, and what we can do to increase that resilience and reduce the adverse environmental impacts. We call it Refocus because that's exactly what we have to do. We have to refocus phosphorus use.
One aspect of this is understanding the flows of phosphorus through the entire food system, through production, through consumption and waste management. And through that, we can then start to understand where the inefficiencies are, maybe where phosphorus is lost within the system. And then once we identify perhaps where it's lost, we can then look for opportunities for circularity, where we can perhaps bring that phosphorus back into the food system.
We're having a look at why some river catchments retain phosphorus more than others, and we want to have a think about whether we could concentrate agriculture in those catchments that retain it a bit better, and whether that would be better for water quality.
One of the interesting characteristics about phosphorus is it's a very sticky element that tends to bind in the soil and build up in huge amounts. We call this legacy phosphorus. Now, historically, we thought that this legacy phosphorus within the soil is not available for crops to use, so it's not agronomically important. So what I'm researching here is actually how much of this phosphorus the crops can take up. And by having a better understanding of this, we may be able to reduce our reliance on fertilizer inputs.
One of the things we're doing is talking to farmers, to get a sense of their ability or their capacity or their willingness to adopt new measures and what constraints they might face. Because without talking to farmers, without speaking to them and bringing them on board, we're not going to be able to move the food system towards phosphorus sustainability.
We all have our part to play in making phosphorus use more sustainable.
Producers can help by using only the phosphorus that the crops need, but also by better utilising the phosphorus that's already in the soil.
Retailers and consumers can reduce food waste, and we can also have less phosphorus intensive diets, so we can eat less processed food and a bit less meat and dairy as well.
We need to capture and recycle more of the phosphorus that is lost from our treatment works.
Globally, we can all recycle phosphorus wherever possible.
If we don't, in another 350 years, we could be facing a major shortage of this vital resource, meaning that more of us will go hungry around the world.